What's up, guys? I am on a quest to find the perfect budget sleeping pad for backpacking. In round one of the sleeping pad showdown, I reviewed four budget sleeping pads and told you which one was my favorite. Well, today I've got three new sleeping pads and I'm afraid I might have a new favorite. Let's get into it. Before we jump into the pads, let me just say that I really appreciate the comments from a few of you recommending some additional budget sleeping pads that you really liked. Two of the pads in this video are because of recommendations from you guys. So if you have other recommendations for additional pads, other gear, or things that you want me to review, let me know in the comments. I love those suggestions. Now, a quick note about sleeping pads before we get into these specific ones. I shared a lot more about our value and other things in round one, so I'll put a link to that video up here. I'm not going to bore you all with that same information today. Each of the three new sleeping pads, as well as the winner from the last round, have a similar R value around 2, and all of them are inflatable sleeping pads, so you'll need to blow them up with your own lung power. And each of these pads cost less than $40, which is a great price for a good night's sleep in the backcountry. All right, let's talk about the specific pads. First, to recap the winner from round one, this is the Sleepingo. I love this sleeping pad. It's 2 inches thick, it's made of 20D nylon, and it weighs only 14.5 ounces. If you watched round one of the sleeping pad showdown, you probably remember that the one thing I was worried about with this sleeping pad was the durability. The one thing I'm concerned about is the durability. Other than that, it was very comfortable, it was very light, very packable, a fantastic sleeping pad. But we've got three new challengers today. We'll see how this one holds up. The first challenger that we'll talk about is from Cascade Mountain. You can purchase this sleeping pad in Costco stores for about $35 if they have it in stores. I had to order mine online, so it cost me $40 with the shipping. I believe you can also get it off of Amazon, but it will cost you $45 there. If you have a friend with a Costco membership and you want this pad, just hit them up and get some free samples while you're there. This sleeping pad is 2.5 inches thick, weighs 20.6 ounces, has an R value of 1.4, and is made of 30D nylon. So slightly thicker than the Sleepingo, but about the same. Let me tell you what I like about this sleeping pad. First of all, it's a little bit wider than some of the other sleeping pads that I've used. I like that so I don't feel like my arms are falling off of my sleeping pad all night. It's also made of a slightly thicker material, like I mentioned, so the durability should be pretty good. And I also felt like it held air quite well. I didn't have to blow in any additional air in the morning after I woke up. It held the air all night and was fairly comfortable when I was sleeping on my back or on my stomach. And the last thing I'll mention that I liked about this sleeping pad is that it has a nice valve on it where you can open one part to inflate the pad where air will not escape when you're not blowing into it. And then you can open it further if you want to deflate the pad. Makes it really easy to blow up the pad without losing air and then deflate it in the morning when you need to. Things that I didn't like about this pad is that I feel like the cells of air are a little bit large, and because of that, the seams in between them just feel a little more deep than some of the other pads that I've slept on. Because of that, if I was sleeping on my side in just the wrong spot or adjusting a certain way, I could feel my shoulder or my hip hit the ground underneath the pad. I didn't really like that feeling. Comfort may come down to personal preference, but for me, this just wasn't the most comfortable pad that I've slept on. All right, so that is the Cascade Mountain. Next is a sleeping pad from a company called Trazon. This sleeping pad cost me $30 off of Amazon, weighs about 22 ounces, and is 4 inches thick. Unfortunately, it does not have an R value listed on Amazon. I would estimate the R value to be around 2, similar to the other pads that I tested. The shell of the pad is made of 40D ripstop nylon. Now, something that's unique about this Trazon pad is actually that it has two valves. There's essentially two sleeping pads put together. You blow up the top portion of the pad as well as the bottom portion of the pad separately, two different valves. Funny story about this, the first night I slept on this pad, I thought it was absolutely terrible because I had only blown up one side of the valve, which means I was sleeping on half of a sleeping pad. The next night, I knew I had to give it another shot, so I blew up both sides of the pad this time, and it was much more comfortable. So what do I like about the Trazon sleeping pad? First of all, the price. It's the cheapest pad that I was testing for this video, and if I can save $10 and get the same comfort, I will take that any day. Another thing I like about it, even though it caused me a bad night's sleep the first night, is the fact that there are two completely separate cells where air can be blown in. With the Trazon, I know that even if the underside pops, that top portion will still provide at least a little bit of comfort for the rest of my trip. Kind of a cool little feature on the Trazon. The other thing I like about it is the way that they've structured the sleeping pad. I just like the way that it feels under my back, and because of the thickness, I can lay on my side and I never felt like my shoulder or my hip were touching the ground. So what do I not like about the Trazon sleeping pad? First of all, the second night that I slept on it, after blowing up both valves, when I woke up in the morning, it felt a little deflated. So it had definitely lost some air overnight. Now, I tried it again, made sure that I closed the valves really well, and that time I didn't lose any air during the night. It was pretty comfortable. But it does worry me that I have to make sure I close those valves just right or I'm going to lose some air during the night. One thing I forgot to mention is that the Trazon does have similar valves to the Cascade Mountain. There is a one-way valve where you blow up the sleeping pad, and then you're able to open it further when you want to deflate the sleeping pad. Again, just makes it nice and easy to blow it up. So that's it for the Trazon. And the last sleeping pad I got to test on this video is the Trekology UL80. Some quick stats about this pad. You can get it for $40 off of Amazon. I was actually able to score it for only $30 on Prime Day, which was a killer deal, but even at $40, this is still a really great deal. I have occasionally seen on Amazon a version for $53 that includes a pump sack, but on Prime Day, there was no way I was gonna pay $20 extra for that pump sack. I've never used one, it just feels like an extra piece of gear to me, but if you like one, it seems like there's usually a version with the pump sack available for the Trekology UL80. Other things you should know about the pad, it is the heaviest of all those in this video at 26.5 ounces. It is 4 inches thick, is made of 40D nylon, so a little bit more durable than a 20D nylon sleeping pad, and has a listed R value of 1.6. I don't worry too much about the R value when I'm looking at a summer sleeping pad. Let me tell you what I really like about the Trekology UL80. First of all, this monster is 4 inches thick. And I know the previous pad, the Trazon, was 4 inches thick as well, but with this pad, it really feels like a true 4 inches. I think that's because of the design of the pad. This one is mostly flat with a little bit of curvature on the sides. In fact, when I sit on this 4-inch thick pad, my bum doesn't even touch the ground. I also appreciate that this one is made out of 40D nylon, similar to the Trazon. It's just going to be a little bit more durable. That, of course, comes with some additional weight, but if you don't mind the extra ounces, the additional durability is nice. Another thing I really like is on the sides of the pad where you lay, it curves up just a little bit, and I feel like that helps me stay on the pad during the middle of the night. It's a small thing, but I feel like it prevents me from rolling off or even from my arms from falling off of the pad. It's also nice and wide, so again, I don't feel like my legs or my arms are falling off of the pad in the middle of the night. As far as things I don't like about this pad, really the only thing that I can mention is the weight. It does weigh 26 ounces, which is almost double the weight of the first pad that we talked about, but for those additional 12 and a half ounces, you get a lot of comfort with the UL80. And that's really the only thing I could think about with this pad that I don't like. Now, before we get to the conclusion and I tell you which pads are my favorite for different conditions, I want to show you what each of them look like inside the bag they came in. So, you can see they're fairly similar size. The Trazon and the Sleepingo are a little bit taller, but really they're all gonna pack up about the same. One thing that I will say I like about the Trazon and the UL80 is that each of them come with this nice elastic band that you can put around the sleeping pad before you put it into the stuff sack. In fact, you could probably even leave the bag at home if you just wanted to use this elastic strap. And there's the UL80. So they both come with this nice elastic strap that really holds it together. Pretty nice. The last thing I'll mention before we get to the thrilling conclusion is that the reason I ordered 3 more sleeping pads is because we were planning a family backpacking trip. I recently took my daughter Chloe and my son Austin backpacking in the High Uintas. It was an amazing time, and these are the 3 pads that we took. My daughter took the Trekology UL80, I slept on the Cascade Mountain, and my son slept on the Trazon. In fact, even before that trip, we had family camping in the backyard where all 3 of us tested out these 3 pads. So, which ones are my favorite? I will tell you that for regular backpacking trips, my new favorite sleeping pad is the Trekology UL80. In fact, on the recent backpacking trip I mentioned, my daughter and I were kind of fighting over who got to use this sleeping pad. She won, of course, because I'm a nice dad, but I really like this sleeping pad. It's the heaviest of the four at 26.5 ounces, but it is just so dang comfortable. But I will tell you that for ultralight backpacking and especially for fast packing, I will still be going with the Sleepingo. You just can't beat the comfort that you get with this pad for the weight. For light trips and fast packing, this is definitely gonna be my go-to. But for regular backpacking trips, the UL80 it is. If you have other budget sleeping pads that you've used and really like or have not liked, let me know in the comments. Or if you have other gear that you'd love for me to do a video about, let me know. I love getting ideas from you guys as far as what gear you'd like to see reviews on. Remember, life is better with some dirt in it.